Welcome to English Honeydew, Unit 7, A Visit to Cambridge, Part 3. This is the third part of this unit, and in this session, we'll begin with this chapter, A Visit to Cambridge. And this is the world famous Cambridge University. This is a map of England where we can see Oxford University and Cambridge University. The writer of this interesting story is Firdaus Kanga. He was born on 1960. He is an Indian writer and actor who lives in London. He has written a novel, Trying to Grow, a semi-autobiographical novel set in India, and a travel book, Heaven on Wheels, about his experiences in the United Kingdom. Semi-autobiographical means dealing partly with writer's life but containing fictional elements. So, in the novel, Trying to Grow, he has written some of his experiences and some are fictional. Fictional means which are imaginary. And as you can see, the picture of the writer, Firdaus Kanga, he's a very unique person. Unique because he is a differently disabled person. That's why he's confined to the wheelchair. From birth, he was born with brittle bones, due to which the movement in his hands and especially the legs were very limited. This is a story of a meeting. Okay, so this story talks about the meeting between two extraordinary people, both of them differently disabled. Now, differently able people are very inspiring because within their limited resources, they have accepted their life and they are living their life so meaningfully. They have never ever given up in their life. They are so independent in spite of some of the weaknesses with their legs. Now, the two differently able people are Stephen Hawking, the greatest scientist, and Firdaus Kanga, who is a writer and journalist. So this is a story about the meeting between these two personalities. Stephen William Hawking was born on 8 January 1942 and he died on 14th March 2018. He was an English theoretical physicist, cosmologist and author who was director of research at the Center for Theoretical Cosmology at the University of Cambridge at the time of his death. This chapter talks about Stephen Hawking. So I am giving you a brief introduction of this great personality. Introduction of this chapter, A Visit to Cambridge by Firdaus Kanga. Now this particular story is actually a travelogue. Now travelogue means a piece of writing taken from his travel experience. So this story is a part of his personal experience, the personal meeting with Stephen Hawking. And it begins with him taking a walking tour through Cambridge. During this tour, his guide mentioned that the famous astrophysicist Stephen Hawking lived there. Now, astrophysicist, that means the person who deals with planets, stars and all. The author had completely forgotten about this, and just as his tour ended, he went to a phone booth to contact him. So this is how the story begins. So let's do the reading of the chapter and I'll be explaining also. So these are the different view of this beautiful university. Before you read, This is a story of a meeting between two extraordinary people, both of them disabled or differently abled, as we now say. Stephen Hawking is one of the greatest scientists of our time. He suffers from a form of paralysis that restricts him to a wheelchair and allows him to speak only by punching buttons on a computer. That means he can't speak. How he communicates with people? By punching buttons on computer. And computer takes out the sound. Not his sound, this computer's sound. So that's how he is communicating. So we realize that we have to be grateful to God for so many things. We don't have to struggle so much. But still, in spite of their struggles, they have no complaints. Only by punching buttons on a computer, which speaks for him in a machine-like voice. Firdaus Kanga is a writer and journalist who lives and works in Mumbai. Kanga was born with brittle bones that tended to break easily when he was a child, like Hawking. So this is the similarity between both of them. Kanga moves around in a wheelchair. The two great men exchange thoughts on what it means to live life in a wheelchair and on how the so-called normal people react to the disabled. Okay, very touching story. We should always be humble and good to disabled people. Okay, so here they are sharing about their experiences and how people react when they meet them. Cambridge was my metaphor. Now, metaphor means that was whenever he thought of England, Cambridge University came to his mind. So it was an image for him that this is England. Cambridge represented England for him. Cambridge was my metaphor for England. And it was strange that when I left, it had become altogether something else. Okay, so he's starting the chapter by telling that what it felt Cambridge is for him and what it was when he left that place. Because I had met Stephen Hawking there. And why the whole concept of Cambridge changed? Because he had met Stephen Hawking. So when he left that university, he had altogether a very different experience. It was a walking tour through Cambridge that the guide mentioned Stephen Hawking, poor man who is quite disabled now, though he is a worthy successor to Isaac Newton. Okay, he is considered as today's Isaac Newton. But that's sad that he is no more with us now. Whose chair he has at the university. And I started because I had quite forgotten that this most brilliant and completely paralyzed astrophysicist. Now here they are given the meaning of astrophysics, scholar of astrophysics, branch of physics dealing with stars and planets. The author of A Brief History of Time. Now this is Stephen Hawking. Now he has written A Brief History of Time, one of the biggest bestsellers ever lived here. When the walking tour was done, I rushed to a phone booth. Okay, he took a tour of Cambridge University with the guide, and immediately after that, he rushed to a phone booth and almost tearing the cord. He was pulling the cord because, you know, he's always confined to a wheelchair, so he can't get up like me and pick up the receiver. So what he did, he struggled a lot and he was literally pulling, tearing the cord so it could reach me outside. And what he did, he phoned Stephen Hawking's house. He was so inspired by Hearing his name, when the guide was explained that, he immediately thought, I am going to meet this person. So the next thing, he ran to, ran means he was confined in a wheelchair. He reached the telephone booth and he called Stephen Hawking. There was his assistant on the line and I told him I had come in a wheelchair from India. Perhaps he thought I had propelled myself all the way. And the assistant thought that he has moved all the way from India to meet him, to write about my travels in Britain. I had to see Professor Hawking. Even 10 minutes would do. Now, he's such a famous person. Now, so he told his assistant that if it could be only for 10 minutes also, but please allow me to come and meet me. So he said, half an hour, he said, for 3:30 to 4. He requested for 10 minutes and the assistant told him that you will be granted half an hour. So what was the time? The appointment time? 3:30 to 4 was the time given to him. And suddenly I felt weak all over. Weak all over means he was so happy and he was nervous also that this great person is ready to meet me. I got the permission to go to his house and meet him. Growing up disabled, he was born disabled. So to grow up in a disabled way, you get fed up with people asking you to be brave. Okay, so that's the first impression people have. They are so sympathetic to that person. And what is the general tendency that we say? You have to be brave, no? Because you are not so normal like us. So as if you have a courage account on which you are too lazy to draw a check. Now, here he has the writer has written it so well. He is telling ki logon ko aise lagta hai ki hamare paas courage ka account hai. Disabled logon ke paas courage ka ek account hai ki hame jab man aaye hum ek usme se check nikal sakte hain. It's so easy. People would say be brave, be courageous, but that is not easy for them. They have gone through a lot in their life, but they have the attitude that they don't have to give up. The only thing that makes you stronger is seeing somebody like you. So why he was more excited? Because all his life he has grown up, he has seen the people's reaction and all, because he was disabled, and now he is going to meet a person who is also a disabled. So he was very thrilled and excited to meet him, and that was making him more stronger, achieving something huge. For him it was something like an achievement. Then you know how much is possible and you reach out further than you ever thought you could. I haven't been brave, said his disembodied. Disembodied means existing without a body. Computer voice. Can't speak, no sound. So that was a computer sound. The next afternoon, I have had no choice. Surely I wanted to say something. Living creatively with the reality of his disintegrating body was a choice. Now, what he wanted to say something? That in spite of all that, he is living very creatively. You know, he is a writer and a journalist. So both are a creative job. He is living creatively with the reality of his. And what is the reality? What is the fact? That he has got a disintegrating body. The body which is decaying was a choice. But I kept quiet because I felt guilty every time I spoke to him, forcing him to respond. Now, he was knowing everything about Stephen Hawking. The guide has already told him. So he was knowing that he has to take so much of pain to punch his keys of the computer, and the computer is giving the sound for him. So whatever he has to communicate, Stephen Hawking has to communicate, it has to be first typed. okay, then only that sound comes out. So the author was feeling very bad also ki usko kitna usko pain dena pad raha hai mujhse baat karne ke liye. So I felt guilty every time I spoke to him, forcing him to respond. There he was. Okay, तो ये सब वो सोच के बैठा था. Firdaus Kanga, he was thinking about all that. So by the time, there he was, tapping at the little switch in his hand, trying to find the words on his computer with the only bit of movement left for him. Only, okay, restricted movement. Legs were not working, hands little bit here and there. So he was tapping and he was coming, and there he was trying to, every so often his eyes would shut in frustrated exhaustion. Wo baat kar raha tha through the computer and he was feeling so exhausted because he had got very pale fingers, very dull fingers. And sitting opposite to him, I could feel his anguish. And the author, Firdaus Kanga, was sitting next to him and he could feel that anguish, that pain, the mind buoyant. Buoyant means intensively active and vibrant. His body is very dull and fragile, but his mind, he has got a brilliant mind, a sharp mind. The mind buoyant, you is silent, buoyant with thoughts that came out in frozen phrases. Frozen means it's very cold. Why it was so cold, the sentences, the phrases which he used? Because that was computer sound. See, when we speak with feelings because human beings are speaking, a living creature. But when Stephen Hawking is punching the keys, it is actually the computer who is giving the sound, which is a non-living thing. So, so beautifully the writer has put the words. He is telling the words were coming out like frozen, okay, without any life. And sentences stiff as corpses. Corpses means dead body. So, he is telling his words and sentences were coming out as if there was no life. A lot of people seem to think that disabled people are chronically unhappy. Okay, we all think that those who are disabled, they are very unhappy. Chronically, he has used, chronically means jo bahut lambe time tak unhappy. Okay, for a very long duration, they are unhappy. We all feel that ki they have got limited resources and all, so they have a very unhappy life. But that is wrong. That notion is completely wrong. I know that's not true myself. The author is telling, I also know that it is not true because he himself is a differently able person. Are you often laughing inside? Children, this chapter, I'm stopping here. I'll be continuing with this chapter in the next session. Do read the chapter. Now let's do the working with language, page number 102 to 103. Question 1. Filling the blanks in the sentences below using the appropriate forms of the words given in the following box. I met a traveler from an antique land. I need special guidance in mathematics. I can't count the number of times I've failed in the subject. The guide called Stephen Hawking a worthy successor to Isaac Newton. His other problems paled into insignificance besides this unforeseen mishap. The meeting was chaired by the youngest member of the board. Some people say yours truly when they informally refer to themselves. I wish it had been a draw match. We would have been spared the noise of celebrations at least. Now this is question number 2. Look at the following words. You have walk and stick. Can you create meaningful phrase using both of these words? It is simple. You can even add ing also. And you can use an article in the beginning. A walking stick, for example. So now you have read, session, walk, toe, smile, and these are the words which you have to write. So the answer is for the first one, a reading session, a walking tour, a smiling face, a dancing doll, a revolving chair, a winning chance. I hope you have understood this much part of the chapter. Do read it. And homework for today is write meanings in notebook, write working with language question number 1 in textbook, write working with language question number 2 in notebook. Thank you and may God bless you. Take care.